friends, welcome back to my Geek and Irvan channel and myself Anirvan, and today I am going to unboxing a new Vivo V9, which many of my subscribers or my viewers used to told me in the Instagram page that please do the unboxing or give the review of this phone. So initially the phone is, I don't know, if you haven't subscribed my channel, please subscribe my channel first, so like this video. So let's see Vivo V9 box, the Vivo quick start guide and the Vivo warranty card, the travel adapter that is a 5V at 2 amps, and this one is a USB cable over here, and this one is a 3.5mm headphone jack that looks like almost the Apple Type's earphone, and this one is a SIM ejector tool. Also had a silicone pouch. Last but not the least is the phone itself. At the back of the phone, this one is a Vivo branding over here, and this one is a fingerprint sensor, and at the top there is a 16 megapixel plus 5 megapixel dual rear camera with a dual tone LED flash. At the left side of the phone, there is a dual SIM card with a micro SD card slot over here, and at the front there is a 24 megapixel front facing camera with a notch over here, but at the right side there is a power on off button with a volume up down button over here. At the top there is a nothing, but at the bottom there is a speaker grill over here, USB port, and the 3.5mm headphone jack. First, talk about the build quality. How the build quality of the Vivo V9? I was just surprised that under the budget of ₹23,000, they are giving a full plastic body over here with a glossy finish. That means if your phone in your pocket, there will be some scratch, there will be the fingerprint magnets over here. So the build quality of the Vivo V9 is not that great according to me. They should at least give the metal unibody design. According to design, it's not that much great. Let's come about the display. How the display it is? The display is very much vivid, very much crispy. No such complaint regarding the display over here. It has a 19:9 aspect ratio with a full HD IPS display over here. The display is very much gorgeous and the sunlight visibility is also very good. So according to display, it's very big thumbs up. Let's go to the Android settings over here. The Android version is the mode settings, the about phone. The Android version is 8.1.0. So that's the audio. So that's a quite good thing they have done. And yes, the processor is a 2.2GHz Snapdragon 626 octa-core processor. The 4GB RAM version, 64GB internal. And it has a camera of about the front facing camera, 24MP front facing camera. And at the back camera, there is giving the 16MP plus 5MP dual rear camera. And if you talk about the battery, then it has a 3260mAh battery. Under ₹23,000, they are only giving the Snapdragon 626 octa-core processor. So that's a quite not a reliable thing for everyone, I hope so, because the Snapdragon 626 octa-core processor, the 10G phone is giving, which are under ₹10,000. So Vivo has to learn these things, that under budget of ₹23,000, they have to give the flagship processor like 636 or the 660. That could be a very better processor. And if you talk about the fingerprint sensor, how it works, see, 1, 2, 3, it unlocks. Again, 1, 2, 3, the fingerprint sensor is very much responsive, is very much fast and very much accurate also. One separate option the Vivo is giving, that is the OTG function. If you enable this function, yes, you can also support the OTG function, so that's quite nice thing. And there is also a motorbike mode, the separate function, if you enable, then it will, the auto reject calls, all the facilities are over here. So if you want to unlock the face recognition feature, yes, you can unlock over here. See, press OK. See, 40%, 60%, 80%, 100%, registration complete. So press OK. So now, how to enable the unlock feature of this Vivo V9? Press this button over here. See, I am making my face down towards the phone. It opened. Again, 1, 2, 3, see, I am putting my fingers, all my fingers are over here. Press this button over here. It's opened. Again, 1, 2, 3. Okay, it's very fast, it's very much accurate. And the notification panel, you can swipe it over here, you can get the notification panel over here, and press the settings over here. So this look like almost an Apple iPhone. I don't know why the Vivo, everything they used to copy the Apple iPhone. Let's talk about the camera. How the camera works. Yes, we all know that the Vivo V9 has a 16 megapixel plus 5 megapixel dual rear camera, and the main highlight of the phone is the camera itself. So let's click one image over here. The shutter speed is very much fast and accurate. Let's see the image now. See the Vivo, the image is very much sharp. It is the image. This is also very sharp. See the Sony branding over here. is very much sharp. And if you talk about the portrait mode, yes, it's just about the portrait mode effect. And I will definitely show you some images in the latter of these videos. The portrait mode is very easy. It is processing now. The picture quality is really very sharp and crispy also. And if you talk about the settings of the camera, yes, it does have the face beauty. It does have the panorama mode over here. And it does have the professional mode also. So that's quite nice thing you are getting. The videos option, the AR stickers, the AR filters also you are getting. And these are the settings which you are getting. Yes, that the timer has been given, the normal mode, the full, the square mode. And yes, you can touch the press like this. You can touch the screen and you can take the image, the voice, the palm gesture is also having. The phone storage, you can keep your photos in the phone or in the SD card slot also. The time mark, the model watermark is all are given, everything, the geographical locations, everything has been given. Let's talk about the front facing camera. Here the front facing camera, they are giving the 24 megapixel front facing camera, which you all know, the Vivo ka mobile mein software acha hai ya nahi. Front facing camera usko acha hona hi chahiye. And yes, the front facing camera is really good. So let's click one photo. Hello YouTube. The pixel, let's see the picture clarity. Yes, the picture clarity is really awesome. It's very much sharp. The Canon branding, the US 750D, every details are over there. So no compromise regarding the front facing camera. And if you talk about the settings, yes, the front facing camera have a settings the same as usual, the rear facing camera. The touch mode, the voice, palm gesture, everything you are getting, the face beauty mode, and the group selfie is also over here. So let's click the group selfie over here. It can take a huge lot of space though, so you can rotate the phone and then you can take the shot over here. See, so that's a quite nice thing. And yes, one more thing, there is also and they are also giving the AR stickers over here. So let's click it over here. And you are also getting the portrait mode effect. So press this button over here, you can get the portrait mode, that's a bokeh mode. And which I don't like the Vivo phones, that is they used to make the face so much whitish, means a plain face, means if you have any pores in your face or any some scrabblings on your face, so that could not be shown by any picture of this Vivo V9 or any Vivo phones. I just like the original image of everyone's face. Weight distribution of the phone is 150 gram almost. It's a very light phone, though it has a 6.3 inch full HD IPS display, that is a 19:9 aspect ratio, but still the weight of the phone is very much light, it's not that much very much heavy. This phone is already having the pre-applied apps, that is a news point over here, the UC browser, the Amazon shopping, the Amazon Prime Video, the Flipkart app is also there inside this the Vivo V9, and with that you are also getting the V App Store. There is a multitasking button over here, see, it also looks like Apple. So everything copy paste. So I don't know why Vivo used to do like this. And if you talk about the call settings over here, so this is the call settings, how it look like. And if you talk about the messaging center, so this is the messaging center, how it look like. And yes, this one is a total theme of the message. So yes, so that is all. Final verdict of the Vivo V9. If you tell me anyone whether I should purchase this phone or not, I will definitely not recommend you to purchase this Vivo V9. Why? First of all, the Vivo V9 build quality is just pathetic. Just pathetic it is, I should say. And one more thing, that yesterday I got my phone. My phone was in my pocket. There are some little bit scratch over here now only. Think about the future. The under rupees 23,000, the build quality really very bad, and I should not recommend you. If it could be in a very in a metal unibody design, then it's perfect, fine. But overall the phone is not very much perfect according to me. If you are very much selfie obsessed, you can take a selfie like this, like this, like this. You can take selfie or you can click the picture with the rear camera also. But if you think that my phone should be in a very good capacity of a battery, or my phone should be in a very much fluid condition, the Snapdragon 626 is not everything. Very downgrade under this rupees of 23,000. I should not recommend you. And yes, I have to test the phone a little bit over here. Why? Because Vivo V9 means I am talking about, especially about the girls. They are always thinking about the selfie. If the selfie is good, the phone is perfect for them. But not that. The phone should be perfect, everything with that. Means the processor, the battery, everything. The camera is not everything for a particular phone. So I will definitely test this phone almost thoroughly so that I could give you the best honest review from me. So thank you my friends, thank you for watching this video. Agar ye video acha laga, please like karna mat bhuliye. If you have any doubts regarding this phone, please comment karna mat bhuliye. So thank you my friends, till now bye bye and Bande Mataram.